you can receive your EOBs back electronically in AdvancedMD's eRemittance review screen. Up on the toolbar, click on the eRemittance review button, and instead of going out to the mailbox each and every day checking for your EOBs, now you'll click on this button each and every day to check back to see if you received any electronic EOBs. Here, you can initially review all the actions taken by the insurance carriers regarding payments and/or denials of claims. Quick overviews, you can see over here the dates that I received them, the insurance carrier, the check numbers, and then the payment codes, and there will be three types. You'll have CHK, which means you received a check in the mail, non-payment, and we can work that out just a little bit later, and then also ACH, which you don't see here, which is direct deposit, and then of course the amount tied to each EOB. To begin working any of your EOBs, just simply find one and double-click. In the subscreen here is going to be a list of all the patients that are tied to that single EOB. And you can see that I have, well, the same patient but listed twice because he has two different dates of services for September 26 and September 29th. Over on the left-hand column, they have what's called an OK column. If there are no errors, it'll list the word OK for each charge. In which case, if there's an OK there, you can click Process OK and it will automatically post all these payments for you and you're done. You can imagine the power that is, especially if you have 50 patients tied to one EOB. There are many reasons why it may not OK. Just simply hover over it and it'll tell you why. For example, another reason might be that when you submit the claim out electronically and you had one subscriber ID number, but then in the meantime you changed it, later you get your electronic EOB back, it'll look at that and find two different subscriber ID numbers that don't match, in which case you won't be OK'd, and you can still hover over it and find out what the error is. In any case, posting payments, even if they're not OK'd here, is still a lot faster than having to type in all this information. And I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to post the payment first for the date of service September 26 for the $96.28. I can choose my deposit date by clicking on the drop-down arrow, but I'm going to leave it blank. Just simply double-click on the payment that you want to post. Pulls up the payment entry screen, and right here you can see how fast this is because I don't have to type in the payment amount, who the payment was from, and it was an ERA check. Also, down at the bottom, I don't have to type in the payment amount again, and you can see that there's a write-off, which is the allowed amount over here. Everything's filled in for me. And if everything looks good here, including the status, I want to bill the next responsible party, which you can see up here. There's no secondary, so if there's any remaining amount, it's going to go right to the patient. Just simply click OK. Automatically, it removes it from your to-do list or your checklist. Now, if I close out of this and I come back here without posting that second payment, you'll notice over to the right the payment amounts. The number in black is the total amount that was paid out by the carrier, and then to the right is the total that has been left to be posted yet, $22.25. Again, if I double-click on it, you'll see there's my $22.25. Again, double-click, pulls up the payment entry screen, double-check all the work, make sure that this is what I want, including the bill next. You can even hover over it and get the payment reason code. Otherwise, just click OK. Now I'm complete. Close out. And it automatically takes that EOB from my to-do list here, or my ERA. Now, if all EOBs were like that, and that simple and that clean, you can see how fast you can get going through this. Let's do another example. You're probably wondering why I have two EOBs here that have no insurance carrier name listed. This is what happens for some offices during their recent transitions from their old billing software into AdvancedMD's new billing software. In other words, you billed out of your old software and it came back electronically to AdvancedMD and AdvancedMD doesn't know what it is. For example, you can double click on one of these and you'll see here your old billing software had different numbers, visit numbers, and so it's not going to match here. The only thing that you can see is the amount that was paid out for each date of service and one that wasn't paid at all. All isn't lost. We can close out of this and you can click on your EOB report, of course making sure that your EOB is highlighted. And here you're going to get a little bit more detail, although the patient's still unknown. However, there's going to be a claim number here that you'll be able to look up and reference, and also you can look over at what was actually paid. So what I'm going to do instead is close out of here, and I'm going to go to my claims center. Now in the claims center, in the EDI tab, or in the EDI reports, you'll also get a McKesson EOB report for that same date, October the 2nd. If you remember, in the ERA it's October the 2nd. So I'm coming back to my claims center. October the 2nd isn't listed here, so I'm going to view my archive reports. Scroll all the way down to October the 2nd, and there it is, my McKesson EOB report for October the 2nd. When I click on it, now for HIPAA security reasons, you're not going to see the patient's name here or the account number, but trust me, they're here. What you want to do is you can scroll along and you can see for each section, it's for each patient. You can see what was billed, $210, the allowed amount, $210, if it met any deductible, just like on a normal EOB, and then over to the right a payment code, PI18, and you can see that the provider was paid nothing. So I want to call the insurance carrier and find out why they didn't pay out any amount. You can scroll down and see other information too with other codes and what was paid, 725, 725. I'm going to close out of the claims center and go back to the eRemittance review screen. And as you saw on that other screen, when I double click here, the $7.25 that was tied to each patient. And again, it was blocked out in the other screen for HIPAA security reasons. So we'll close out, and what you're going to do here is you're going to pull up those patients individually in AdvancedMD by clicking on the patient button and posting the $7.25 and then posting a $0 payment, calling the insurance carrier and rebilling. Once you're done posting all the payments, you can come back in here and then just simply dismiss this. But I won't dismiss it for now because I do want to call the insurance carrier and find out why we didn't get paid on some of the line items you saw in the EDI report. Let's do another example. Let's say somebody posted the payment outside of the eRemittance review screen that you see here, perhaps in the payment entry screen. I'm going to double click on September 29th, and in this EOB, you won't be able to tell in this screen exactly if the payment's been posted or not, but simply double click on one of the patients, and you'll see in this screen that there's nothing down at the bottom. So this tells me that the payment has already been posted. I can simply click cancel, of course checking the rest of them. So after I figured out that all of them have been posted within the EOB, I want to close out. While this is still highlighted, I'm going to dismiss it because the payments have already been posted. And then it tells me that the select check has a non-zero balance. Again, because it's already been posted, I will say yes. And it removes it from my to-do list of EOBs to post payments for or to work on. And then finally, let's do one more. Let's take a look at the one that we didn't get paid out on at all. Double-click on it, and you can see none of the payments were made. So what I recommend doing is closing out of here. And even though you can click on the EOB report here, which will give you some information, you can see it doesn't give us all the information or the payment reason codes from the insurance carrier why it was denied. So the next step is to close out of here and to go back to my claims center EDI reports. Now again, this one was for October 12th. I want to pull up the EDI report for back in my claims center. I'm going to view the archived reports and scroll down to October 12th. There's my McKesson EOB report. And of course, for HIPAA security reasons, most everything in here is blanked out. But when we scroll along, you can see for some of these, for example, in the second line item here, the bill amount was $55, the allowed is $47.25, and the deductible, which hasn't been met, is $47.25. So again, that's going to be the patient's responsibility, and that's why the insurance carrier paid out zero on this. Now I'm going to leave this here until I get a chance to call the insurance carrier on some of them, and I can go ahead and print out my McKesson EOB report for October 12th. And then of course for some of the ones in this EOB here that the deductible wasn't met on, I can still double click on them and post a $0 amount and say deductible not met for the status and then bill the patient directly. At least I can clean some of them up. But again, I'll leave all this up till I'm able to clean everything in this EOB, and then after, I'll go ahead and dismiss it.